All right, welcome to Lakehouse Live. I am Ash, and today we have Joe P in the studio. He is going to start by taking it away with a song, so go ahead. So that was Joe P's song, Color TV, that came out in 2022 off of French Blonde was the EP, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nice.
That's it.
So tell me a little bit about all of that. How is recording that EP? What, was there any kind of theme with it? Any inspiration?
I did a lot of it here, actually. A lot of the drums and like piano and stuff like that. I remember we did it all here. But I don't know. There's some stuff on there that was like revamped songs and some stuff that was like totally fresh. And it, with this whole thing of like being a solo artist or whatever, each EP is like me trying to get closer to figuring out like, how do I want to sound? I don't know. Yeah. When you're in a band, it's just built in. Like you meet up for practice and the way that person plays drums and bass and guitar and whatever is what you sound like. You like don't get a choice anymore. But then when everyone's, it's just you, I'm like, oh, I have to like find a, like, oh, this song, I should get this drummer and this guitar, you know?
Yeah.
Which I didn't really do that either. It was a lot of just like, I played a lot of the instruments on it. Cause as I'm writing, I like to kind of like try stuff out and record it. And then I end up leaving it a lot of the time. But yeah, so it's a lot of just me kind of like discovering what the heck I'm doing. I got like no clue every
as
time.
As we all are all the time.
Yes, exactly.
And I do think it's kind of cool that you, being a solo artist, get to experience working with other musicians mm-hmm. constantly, and yeah. you're always developing yourself. And it's almost like you don't ever get that like core sound of like that's you. It's yeah. like you get to experience all versions of you.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
really nice.
Yeah, it's fun because each song can be like, oh, what's this going to be? It doesn't feel quite as much like. Usually in a band, you'll jam and stuff in like a circle for 2 hours and like not talk to each other and like. You come up with something that way.
Yeah.
And then it's cool because you're very just kind of like, okay, that's what we made. Like, that's it. I'll go write lyrics and see you guys later. But yeah, with the solo thing, it's a bit more like you walk in, it's more like I can do anything. Like you can have every flavor of ice cream. So you're almost like, I don't know what to do. Like it's a lot harder that way almost. But yeah, I think the good part is that the song always tells you what to do every time is what I've started to learn that. I tried less to like have a sound and now I'm more just like, this is this song and it wants like a bass here and it wants no guitar, you know, whatever it is. And I just follow that.
That's amazing. And I know you kind of said that it does make it a little bit harder, but have you ever found yourself just like so stuck in the middle of a song and like, where am I going with this and spending so much time on it?
Yeah. Like a year or two, like you never, there's so much time. It's insane sometimes, but yeah, because you get the spark, right? You get the cool little spark of the idea and you're like, yes. And in that moment you feel like you can, like, you're going to write this whole song. This is great. But what happens is it's like a little bit and you go there and then you go as long as you can until it runs out of gas. And like, that's always what it feels like. And sometimes it's like you have a chorus and a verse. Sometimes you have like 80% of the song done and sometimes you have one line, like you don't know.
Yeah.
My phone is just filled with, literally when we were in that room, I like picked up a guitar and like we were getting the B-roll stuff and I like started playing this dumb thing and I was like, that's pretty good, I'm going to record it. Like it's nothing. There's no lyric, there's no idea. I don't know what the song is or if it even is a song. But sometimes you get that spark and you just try as long as you can until that runs out. And then naturally as like a musician, artist, like, we're kind of not lazy, but it's almost like if that spark isn't there, we're like, well, I don't want to do it anymore.
Yeah.
I just want the magic stuff, you know?
Yeah.
But
I'm no stranger to that too. Yeah. I feel like I have just constant like voice memos and notes in my phone of like lyrics, like, oh, like a phrase I heard somewhere. And I'm like, oh, I'm going to use that one day.
It's great. But you got to finish it. That's the hard part. No one tells you that. The spark feels like that's the whole thing. I could do this all day. And it's like, no. The work part is actually when the spark is gone and you keep working on it for 2 more hours until you get another spark, you know? But it's, you know, so I've learned that I kind of have to just keep, you know, keep trying to do that. And when you work like that, the song again just tells you because you're just so close to it that you're like, I don't know anymore. I just like, I hate this. I want it to be finished. That once it's finished, you're like, oh, that's what it was supposed to be, I guess. Like, I didn't even do that. You know, it doesn't feel like you sat down and were like, I'm going to make this kind of a song.
Yeah.
You know? That rarely happens, I think, you know, or even lyrically, I don't ever. Like whenever I release a song, my manager texts me. He's like, you need to do like a quote, I guess, about the song for like blogs and write-ups or whatever.
Yeah.
And it's like, what's the song about? And I'm like, I don't know. It's not like I can say this song is about this, like for sure. It's almost like, I don't know. I was like in my basement. It was like 4 a.m. And I just like started singing this one line over and over again and like crying. And like, I didn't know what, like, you know, I'm not going to say that, you know, I guess I just did, but it's like, that's not the way, you know? So I'm like, that's not what they want. They want me to say like, it's about when you're in a relationship and the person goes, which is, it's just, I just think things are like deeper than that. Like, just, I think it can be applied to more things. So I'd rather not say like, oh, it's about this exact thing, you know?
Yeah.
So.
And I think it's easier for people to relate if, mm-hmm. if it's not this specification that you put to it. Yeah, so
exactly.
Yeah. And I think that's the beauty of what you kind of do. You spend so much time doing everything yourself. Mm-hmm. Whereas like a lot of people, especially in like major label world, they have like 4 and 5 producers behind them, like constantly like weighing in. And a lot of that music is amazing. Yeah. And obviously what they do is so great.
Yeah.
But it can almost take away from like, you know, what the artist truly wants to do.
Yeah. It just depends on the person. There's different kinds of people I've learned where it's like, I'm the kind of person where I was literally telling someone this the other day where like, I'm so passive about things that, you know, in the songwriting world, obviously, like if you work with someone, if you don't like something, you have to say, I don't like that, especially if it's for your project or your music. And I'd be like, I would just sit there and be like, okay, I know I'm going to hate this song that we're making, like with this like co-writer or whatever, or producer or whatever. But like, I would sit through the whole thing because I was like, I'm not going to stand up and be like, no, I hate this. I just don't have that in me.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, I'll go home and fix it all myself in my basement, which is like not healthy. But that's, you know what I mean? I realized like I can't really change that. So rather than try to change that and be like, I'm going to start like saying like, I don't like this, you know, it's more like, what if I just don't have the person there? And then I just start at like just me doing it, you know, and I have worked with people since that decision where it's been good. And I think it's because now I know that like how to do it a little more in like a healthy way, as opposed to just like, this is like bad, you know, and then not saying anything at all. And then blaming everyone else. It's like, no, you sat there. Like, but I told someone, I was like, I'm so passive and like non-confrontational that if there was an issue where they had to get rid of like a limb and they did the wrong one and I saw it happening, I might be like, I'll just tell them after. Like, I can't tell them. They're going to be so like bummed out. I don't know. I don't think so. But I sometimes think, man, I probably would. I'd let them go.
Oh my God.
And then I would just be like, it's fine. And they'd be like, why didn't you say anything?
But, it's tough too to you know have so many people in the room and they might have a certain title to them and then you don't want to insult somebody and all of those different things.
It's supposed to be fun.
Yeah, it takes like, the fun out of it.
When you're in a band, you can say like, "Dude, no, like I hate
you." That's your friend.
Yeah, you can do anything you want. When it's like, "Hey, we just met today, and now we're writing a song about like the deepest thing ever, and now we have to become best friends." It's like it's a different type of thing. Like sometimes that's. A good thing because of that, because it's so fresh and there's no one knows anything about each other and now you're coming together and there's no baggage or anything. But it also, it's like you really have to warm up quick to that person in order to do that, which I think I learned how to do that. So it's a little less like, you know, I sit there and be like, oh, I'm not going to say anything, and a little more like, oh, I feel like this person's my best friend. I'll just tell them I don't like this, you know?
Yeah.
So it's a little different now, but in the beginning of doing it, I like wouldn't allow myself to warm up to anyone that much. So that's good.
Well, it's cool to see like the development that you've been able to have over time with creating. Yeah. All right, let's let you play another song.
Okay.
All right, so he is going to play All That I Dream About off of, again, French Blonde that came out in 2022. So go ahead and take it away.
All right. Smoke.
probably true in the whole town.
Thank you for playing that. That was amazing. So you are no stranger to this space, obviously. You've spent, you know, so many years in Asbury Park mm-hmm. and with Deal Casino and then on your own and obviously so much time at Lakehouse. How does it feel to kind of be back here and you know, in this space creating again?
I love it. It's like, because when it initially started that way, I was just so dumb. Like, it's one of those things where it's like this, when you can go back to a place, the same exact place and do the same things there as far as like making music there. But years later, it's cool because nothing's like that. Like, you don't get that chance with things. You just look back and go, oh man, like I wish I didn't wear that shirt in eighth grade. It was so stupid. Like, I thought that was so cool. Why did I think it was cool? And now it feels a little more like I can look back and be like, that was so stupid what I was doing in my head. Like, I just, that version of me. But I had to, like, years had to go by for me to learn
anything.
Yeah,
you had to get to that point.
Yeah, so I like it because it's like a brand new place to me.
That's amazing.
Yeah, to me it feels like a new, like I remember walking in this room when it was like, they didn't have anything. It was just like floorboards and, you know, like studs and stuff. So it's weird because it's really just, a place is just a place at the end of the day. Like, you really, it's like how you change and come back can be like, oh, this is like the greatest thing ever now, you know?
Absolutely.
So, but yeah, I feel like I wasn't like there mentally yet at that time to like really understand and appreciate it. You know what I mean?
Definitely.
It was just like, oh, it's like a studio. Okay. It's like, yeah, it's a really nice studio and like you can do a lot of cool stuff there. So, and now I feel like I'm fully aware of that, which is cool.
Yeah. You can like walk in, be fully at home and fully present and understand everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah.
And you're going on tour soon. So.
Yeah, I am.
What's going on? Obviously, some songs have come out and you're releasing.
Yeah, new music is coming and probably throughout that tour, songs will be coming out, which is cool. But yeah, it's going to be like a West Coast thing mostly. And then we work our way back, which is cool. But I mean, I did my first headline tour ever on the East Coast and that was terrifying because I was like, when I saw, you know, because a lot of this now is just getting emails from people who do those things and are like, here's where you're going and these are the venues. And I'm like, okay, like New York, okay, like New Jersey. And then I would see like Washington, D.C. And I was like, I never played for anyone there. Like, I never played a headline show there.
Yeah.
Like, who's going to come to this? You guys are crazy. And then it would go as far as like Akron, Ohio. And I was like, you guys are just trying to embarrass me and have me show up to these places. And people would be like, there's three people here. Like, but it was great. And there was a ton of people. And I was just super surprised. And it was like, and it was one of those weird things where it's like, that's the goal. Like, the goal is you want people to go to the shows. You want people to listen.
Mm-hmm.
And then when they do, you're like embarrassed. Like, I walk out on stage to a sold out show or something. And I should be like, yeah, that's right. Like, this is the whole point. But it's weird. You just feel like you, it's almost nice. It's refreshing because I almost learned that like, oh, that's not why I do it. I really, like sometimes I do have thoughts where I'm like, I guess like I do this like for me, whatever, but like, you know, as hard as I'm like trying to write a song or posting whatever, you know, it's like obviously I'm like trying to get people involved, you know,
and on it.
But then when I'm there and they're all there, I'm almost like, oh God, I wish I was alone in my room playing guitar. Like, this is freaky. And then we started playing and it's so much fun and it was great. But the initial first show in Washington, D.C. that was sold out, I was like, this is crazy. And it was just weird because it's like a birthday party for yourself. Like you're like, my name's on the thing.
Yeah, it like, feels like a really big celebration.
It is. It's a huge celebration. But like I've always been the opener, which is so easy because you just get to be – everyone expects nothing. They're like, we're not here for you. We didn't pay for you. You owe us nothing. And we expect nothing, which is so good. It's the perfect recipe for like, I'm going to go out there and be crazy and do the best I can.
Yeah, yeah.
Because there's nothing to lose. And you only have like 30 minutes. So you can do your best stuff. Like you don't have to talk to the crowd because there's no time. And then the headline thing, it was like, okay, you have to play for like an hour and 20, hour and 15. And like, they're already there for you. They paid to be there. Like every show I said, like, yeah, exactly. They expect something. I'm like, they already think I'm good. I'm only good at trying to play for people that are like, I don't know what this is going to be all about and trying to win them over. Like it's like a competitive thing, I guess. But once they're all on your side, it's almost like that's where the real work is. That's where like, that's the real show. Like that's a real show when you have to like entertain people who are already kind of into it. But once we started doing them, I realized it's super easy. Because everyone's stoked, like everyone's cool and there.
Yeah,
for
everyone's
you.
Excited to see you.
Yeah, so it's nice. It's a little less underdog feeling, and like you're not punching up. Instead, you know, it's more so you're like you're just trying to have a party. Almost is the way I started kind of seeing it. It was less like I need to like prove these people that I'm good or something, and it was more, all right, let's just have fun. They're already stoked. Let's just don't mess up. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, that's an awesome way to look at it. And like, even if you do mess up, people are like,
doesn't matter.
Oh, we don't care.
I messed up so many times. It was in so many weird things happened that I was like, I wasn't ready for this. I didn't know what to do. But then you think, oh, wait, I've opened for a million people. I am ready.
Yeah.
Because you've done all that work, you know, but you just don't realize it, I guess, until you're standing there in the situation.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Whenever I see, you know, like people come off stage and they're like so bummed because they like missed that one note or something. I'm always like,
no,
you could stop in the middle of your performance and be like, I'm sorry, I messed up. And the whole crowd would be like, hell yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I used to think breaking a string or singing a wrong lyric or any of that stuff was like, you messed up and ruined your own show. And now I like pray for stuff like that because that's the stuff that it's like, you leave there going like, that'll never happen again, just like that. If we played perfectly and didn't mess up and like the lights were good and everything, it's like, okay, they're gonna go do that in like Chicago tomorrow.
Yeah.
You know, whereas like when you do that in, and then like your guitar breaks in half or a string falls off or like you forget a word and you're like, we gotta start over. It feels embarrassing in that you've like ruined the show, but really you've given people like a thing, like you're in it together now, in on like an inside joke.
Yeah, it's like the one experience you guys had and you shared in a room together.
Yeah, so it's funny because you practice that doesn't happen. And then I hit a point where I was like, I kind of want that to happen. Because then it's like, you know, it's like people are on your side for that reason even. Because then they know, you know, if you're like messing up in a way that it's like unprofessional or like a bad vibe, that's different. But when people can see in your face that like you're like, oh no, like what do I do, everyone loves it because they're like, yeah, that's why we don't do it. Like you're crazy up there for doing this, you know what I mean? Like we don't want to do this. Like that's how we paid
money for you to come for you to do this for us.
So I think they like to see like you mess up the way they would too, and like, and you're like, okay, cool.
Yeah, it makes everyone feel real and genuine and not like this godlike person.
Yeah, no one's like playing a show and it's separated, you know, it's like one big party. So
yeah,
it's cool.
That's cool. Mm. All right. So before we let you play your last song, I'm going to ask a random question out of our question bowl.
Wow. I've been looking at the question bowl all day here. I'm wondering about that. So you pick one question out of that?
Just one, usually.
No way. I love it. There's so many in there. I love it.
And then everyone, you know, answers it in their own way. And
yeah.
It's always a really interesting time.
It's kind of scary.
Sometimes it's like the simplest question and the answer that someone has is just so out there.
Wow.
So that's why I like it, because it's very different.
Yeah, I like it. Oh, no.
Like, this is just a joke question.
Okay, love it. Is it the astronaut joke? I mean...
It is not. It's not like the astronaut joke.
Okay.
I have to ask it because it's here.
Sure.
And I'm probably going to pick another one because it's not a genuine question.
Yeah.
But it says, do you know what I did last summer?
Do I know what you did?
Yeah. Do you know what I did last summer?
Last summer, did you go on any trips at least? Can you give me?
I don't even remember what I did last summer. No, I didn't go on any trips.
Wait, so it's not a question. Wait, what's the question?
It's just someone saying, do you know what I did last summer? Because they want me to ask you if you know what I did.
I don't know. That's
the
answer.
Yeah, you don't.
See, because, guys.
Because we don't just like talk every single day, you know? We're not like best friends. Well, now we are.
Now we are.
Because we just experienced this
together.
Now
I'm going to know what you did last summer, but not right now. I don't know about the last summer. I'll know about this one.
Yeah, next time we do this, you're going to be like, I'm going to ask the same question. You're going to be like, I do know what Ash did last summer.
I like that. Yeah, I like that.
So I'm going to ask you a real question.
Sure. We'll see.
Hopefully it's a real question.
I mean, yeah.
I'm looking at everyone in the background behind the cameras because I feel like one of them wrote that question.
Oh, wow. Did they? No? No? Oh,
interesting. They won't admit to it.
No, I know they wouldn't. Just a nice creepy question.
All right, this one's sticking out. Okay. All right.
Nice.
Apple juice or orange juice?
Whoa. You know what's crazy is I haven't thought about this in a while. I think orange juice is probably that. It's more timeless.
Oh.
What?
Oh, people are disagreeing behind us.
Hell?
I agree with you. I would say orange juice
too. It's more
too.
Timeless. Like apple juice is like, at a certain point, I think it's too much, right? It's like.
I don't know.
It's just straight apple juice on its own?
Wow.
You water it down or no?
Apple cider.
Well, sure, I like apple cider.
That's different than apple juice, though.
I feel like apple juice sounds like, like an apple juice. Like a little, like, oh, an apple juice. orange juice is like.
I like picture like a kid drinking apple
juice.
Yeah,
it's very, I guess so. It's like a Capri Sun or something, which I had 2 days ago. So I guess I can't really.
Oh my God, I haven't had one in so long.
They're great.
Just like straight sugar.
It's sugar
beverage.
Water. Yeah, you drink it, it's gone in 5 seconds and you're like that, I feel worse. Like this is terrible. yeah, I don't know. Orange juice to me, I like pulp orange. Like
I do too. Like a fresh.
I knew it was just gonna get worse when I said that. But I don't know. Yeah, I think it's like apple juice is too much like apple water, whereas orange juice is like this is like amazing. This is like a crazy amazing.
You're like
thing.
I have so much vitamin C in me
now.
Yeah,
it's all terrible for you though, right? Like there's.
I mean, unless it's like really like fresh squeezed. Yeah, totally.
Yeah, which can you even get fresh squeezed apple juice? That's what I mean. I feel like I've only had fresh squeezed.
I feel like you have to go to like some like a juice place to get that.
You know what? I guess like a smoothie with an apple in it is apple juice.
Yeah, it's been blended down.
Pureed apple.
Yeah, pureed.
I would take a pureed apple maybe over orange juice maybe. Okay. We'll see. But
so what is your like favorite beverage of all time?
Wow, that's great. I think, Coca-Cola is the best thing. It's so bad for you. It's terrible. It's the worst thing in the world. But I think it's truly the greatest. Like thing ever. Like I really do. I think it's the best like drink you can have.
Wow.
And it's funny because everyone I know drinks like, cause I like haven't drank soda in a bit as like a thing that I'm like, I'll have a soda today. It's like, if I'm having like pizza or something, I'm like, damn, I kind of have to.
It's like a treat moment.
Yeah. It pairs with it. It's like a thing. But like, I've been trying to do like Diet Coke. And or Coke Zero, it's kind of nasty, but people love Diet Coke
as much.
Everyone I know loves Diet Coke, so I'm like, all right, I'll try one. And then I tried it out, and I'm like, just don't even have anything. Just have water. Like stick to. I mean, I've done it, and it's okay, but it's like, it's not worth it. I'd rather just go all the way. And this little bodega on the corner of my street, they have like the bottle, like Mexican Coke with the real sugar or cane sugar, I guess, in it. It tastes totally different than normal Coke, but it's great.
Like a good little supplement.
Yeah. Like, and they have Capri Sun. That's where I get these things that I get. So
sweet.
I got.
You just walk down to the bodega and you get like a Capri Sun.
Yeah, it's
and,
great. It's so good. It's so good. It's amazing. And they don't speak any English. So I go in and I'm just like, where's the Coca-Cola? And like full on do not speak any English. But I've been getting better at Spanish. So I can just go in there and like.
That's great.
Yeah. I love it. It's awesome. But.
All right, Coca-Cola.
Okay. Coca-Cola. I think so. I think it's the best. It's the best beverage. I think. As far as that. What about you?
I wasn't prepared for this.
You can do it. You got it.
I guess I like seltzer a lot. So
interesting.
Like almost every form of seltzer I love.
Okay.
So I almost like have to have one every day.
What's your brand?
A lot of the time it's Spindrift.
Which
is like I guess they don't classify it as seltzer because it's supposed to be like more natural.
Right.
But like pineapple
is
the best flavor for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Coca-Cola and seltzer.
Yeah, I like that.
This is, this could be even like off the camera or people. I love Olipops a lot.
What are those?
They're supposed to be like a natural version of soda. So they have like root beer, Coca-Cola, or vintage cola whatever.
I think they have these at this place, Sickles, down the road from my house.
They have them at a lot. They have them at like Wegmans and Target
now, too. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, and they're in cans and stuff.
Yeah.
But it's like great. Zero everything still.
That's what they say. I mean,
who knows? They're really good.
They taste really good.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. I have had those. They're great.
Yeah. That's a good one.
It's so sad that at a certain point, something happens where there's like, you wake up and there's like this rule, like we just stop drinking soda. Like
we
it's like you're not allowed to just have soda all the time anymore.
You can't do it. It's
you
so
can't
bad.
Do it. It's so bad for you and you just die. But it's the best thing in the world when you finally do it and you're like, wow. So that's why I say Coca-Cola is because you can't really have it all the time. So seltzer to me is smart because you can do that all the time.
Yeah, I do drink it often.
You ever do polar seltzer with the orange, like creamsicle one?
I have had that one, yeah.
It's crazy.
It's very good.
It's probably the closest I've gotten to being like, okay, this is the best tasting like non-soda thing.
It's very, that one in black cherry is really good.
Yeah, it's crazy how crazy different each brand is. Because like the Wegmans store brand is good sometimes, like the cherry one.
Yeah.
And I just got Schweppes, it wasn't that good. Canada Dry is okay.
Yeah, it's all right.
Do you ever do plain? Do you ever do the plain seltzer, like no flavor?
If it's the last resort. Oh,
okay, you won't go for it though. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, my friend Tony does, he only has plain seltzer.
Wow.
It's like the cartoon character.
I almost
want
to like call him a sociopath for that.
It's 100%. It's 100%. Because he goes, you have seltzer? I go, yeah. And I said, in the pantry, I have like three flavors. And I look and he's got the standard one. I was like, I have like the orange and the lime.
Like, you know, you can just mix that
you
with
be
like
a person.
Something
and
else.
Like, yeah, he's like, nah, I love just the straight up like water with bubbles. And I was like, okay, man, just that's so weird. But yeah, he lives by that. And Diet Coke. He's like an insane Diet Coke guy.
Okay.
But it's like he's like that guy, like black coffee, Diet Coke, cigarettes, and plain seltzer. Like a cartoon character.
Yeah, like
in a
pretty
show.
Pretty classic.
Yeah.
It's like an American classic right there.
Exactly. And he would love to hear that. He loves that like whole thing. So that I think he has like it's almost like he's just keeping up on like a persona. I don't know. Maybe he goes home alone and he's like drinking like flavored seltzer and, you know, normal Coke, but like I got him one of those Mexican Cokes and he wouldn't drink it because he's like, I only do Diet Coke. I was like, dude, this is like cane sugar. Like, yeah, this is like a different thing. It's not even like normal Coke. Like, you'll love it.
Yeah.
But he's like, no, that's the thing that blows my mind is the people who prefer Diet Coke over normal Coke.
I just don't even drink it.
You're lying. Yeah, you're just lying. There's no way that can be, you know, but I don't know. I guess it's like apple juice and orange juice. So.
I mean, this is why we have the question segment.
I love it.
We just had a full-on conversation about beverages.
Yeah. No, it might have been the most in-depth we've gone.
Right?
It's true. That's where it all starts at the beverage. So, yeah. All right. Cool.
All right. So before we go and let you play your last song, do you have anything that you want to say?
No. No, I don't know. I just talked about seltzer for way too long, so anything else is just surplus. Like, it's too much.
Well,
but thanks for having me.
Of course, yeah. We obviously you are no stranger to the space, and we'll be seeing you again soon. And we, you know, have to obviously wish you good luck on
thank
tour.
Thank you.
I hope you have a blast, and all the venues have great little random shared experiences.
Yeah, I hope.
And for everyone watching, if you enjoy what we've been doing here with Lakehouse Live, please make sure that you like and subscribe and comment so that we can continue to support artists, whether they be national names or local acts. That is why we do this, so it's really important to us. All right, so we're going to let Joe play his last song titled Off My Mind, which came out this year in 2023. So take it away.
Mm.
tell you I'm fine. One more vodka soda, then you'll never even know that I'm blind. I used to wonder why you never said goodbye, but now you're off my mind. Got myself another lover, God, I love her, I'll never stop. Take her out and drive her around and show her all of our favorite spots. I used to sit and cry, I felt like I could die, but now you're off my mind. Toast in the tub with all my ducks in a row, wearing all of my clothes, but I still put my hand around the headrest in my Honda Accord. And no one's there to hold on to the wheel. Every blonde hair in the corner of my eye. Now you're off my mind. I can't believe what they're saying. You don't live in Jersey anymore. You went to fight off your genetics, and you heard the West Coast had the cure. Kids grow up while you're just getting old. You used to be so sure, and now you never know. But it's okay, yeah, it's alright, 'cause I'm too far from you to fall in. But we'll be better by the summer. You'll come out from underneath your coat. I'll be making toast in the tub with all my ducks in a row, wearing all my clothes. Jump off and
if you like this,